Hi everyone, good morning. This is Dan. Welcome to Engelgeist. For those of you that are new, welcome. For those of you that are returning, welcome back. For those of you that support me over on Patreon, thank you so very much for your subscriptions. I do greatly appreciate them. They mean the world to me. This is the weekly forecast. It is an all signs forecast, so it is a collective reading for everyone. I do speak in broad terms. You need to figure out if and where it fits in your life, if at all. If it doesn't fit, that's okay. It doesn't mean that, you know, anything's broken or you're doing anything wrong. It just may not be your reading at the time that you're seeing it. It is a weekly reading. It's the underpinning energy for the week. It's originally created for Sunday, July 30th through the 5th of August. So, you know, each card that I pull from the tarot will represent for maybe a day or two, possibly three, depending on how you're moving through the week. It's open to ebb and flow, so some of you may experience one of these cards throughout the entire week. Some of you might experience all of these cards and then some. It's really kind of take what you need and leave the rest. It's a collective reading, so like I said, I speak in broad terms. What else do I need to say? For those of you that are new to the channel, please check out my daily, sorry guys, I've been in a rough period, I'm just going to be honest. I feel a little, I don't know. The cards have been good, which is nice, but I feel off, let's just say that. Alright, for those of you that are new, please check out the drop-down menu underneath any of my daily readings or my weekly readings. In there is some housekeeping rules, things I want you to think about when utilizing the channel, what decks I'm using in the reading, how to follow me on social media, either at Instagram or my Facebook business page if you're interested. If you're interested in a private reading, that would be where you would need to reach out to me at either of those two places to request a private reading. Please know that I will not try and reach out to you to sell you a reading ever if you're a watcher on my channel. So if anybody does reach out to you, it's not me. You always have to initiate the conversation. So please keep that in mind. What else? Oh, easy ways to support the channel. Please hit the thumbs up button if you enjoy the content. Subscribe to the channel if you're new and hit that notification bell so that you get notified when I put up new content, which is daily. Share the video out. Leave me a question or comment. I greatly appreciate those too, especially if the reading resonates for you. I do want to say hello to a new subscriber, Linster's List. I just got notified of your new subscription, so thank you for subscribing. I'm going to start calling out subscribers if I get emails on it. Sometimes I get them and I'm not aware, like YouTube doesn't notify me. What else? Even though this reading is created for July 30th through August 5th, it's not solely set for that date, those dates. Like if you're seeing it on a different date, I do believe that readings can be timeless and that they can find us when we need them. So if you're seeing this reading on a different time, at a different date, during a different year, whenever, and it still applies or makes sense to whatever's going on in your situation or your life, by all means utilize the reading when you're seeing it. And that's with any of my readings. You know, I believe that spirit has a way of finding us the right information when we need it, as long as we have faith in it and trust. So let's see what these cards have in store for us this week. Let me just get these clarifying shuffle. All right, here we go. So at the beginning of the week, we have the Spirit of Rings, productivity and endurance. So this is the Knight of Pentacles, essentially. I like how this is set up because we have this mountain, but the path is kind of golden. Right? The Knight of Pentacles is a very slow, that's why it's like productivity and endurance. It's a very slow, practical, oh, sorry, one moment. Okay, sorry about that. very slow, practical, reliable, stable energy. It's earth energy, so it can be associated with the signs of Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus. If we're dealing with any of those types of signs or people with those heavy placements. What I like about this card is we see the challenge of the mountain, right? But the path is golden leading up to that pinnacle. There is a patience that comes with the Knight of Pentacles that can be a little bit annoying because if we want to move quickly, this is not a card of that. This is a card of steady, practical discernment. Taking each step, thinking it through, taking the next step, thinking it through, moving with a sort of focused intention. So we want to take this energy and use it to face our challenges in the early part of this week. If we have a big project ahead of us, if we have something that we're working on that we really desire, we need to understand that we are strong enough, capable enough, durable enough, steady enough, grounded enough. This could be a card to remind us to ground as we move forward and face the challenges that are presented to us or that we see on the, you know, horizon, so to speak. But the path here is golden, meaning with each step that we take, as long as we're measuring it and not freaking out, as long as we're channeling our Knight of Pentacles energy of this slow and steady wins the race, we will get there. We will succeed, right? This is a card of dependability. We can be dependable to ourselves, to others, or there might be someone around us that we can depend on. They could be, situations could feel like they're slowing down or not moving as quickly as we would like. But understand that in this slowness is an opportunity to mull things over, think things through, look at all aspects, take the time and embrace sort of the patience or the moment. That I'm going to say this, where's my little pointer? This giant pentacle here at the top of the mountain speaks to this idea of, you know, being in the now. You know, it's almost giving me Ace of Pentacles vibes, right? Of being very present moment, focused on the goal. Yes, there's a mountain, or yes, there's a challenge. Yes, there may be steps or plans to make, but we can take it step by step, bit by bit, piece by piece, reflecting on each choice, decision, action that we take, and do so in a steady, stable manner. This can be within relationships, this can be at work, wherever we need this, or we see challenges, or we're facing challenges, there is this end game goal, that pentacle sitting at the top of that mountain, that we see very clearly, and we can work our way up towards it with this stable, dependable, reliable energy. I hope that makes sense to you guys. So let's look at the midweek card. The midweek card is the Nine of Wands. This is test of strength and perseverance. Nine of Wands is often depicted as the wounded warrior or the gentleman that's like kind of like got the bandage on his head and he's standing behind his border of wands that he has staked into the ground. Nines are about personal completion, right? When we're coming to almost that ending, that 10, wands are that of the spirit, right? The drive, the action that like wells up from within us. I have to say this as a general, you know, collective energy between these two cards for this week. I feel like this is the setup or this is the planning stage for maybe the month of August or the rest of the year for some of you, however that looks. I like the stability of the Knight of Pentacles. And then the Nine of Wands, to me, is always a card of, although we've been to battle, although we've been through hardship, we take that hardship or each of those wands and we use them to create that wall or that barrier, right? We work smarter, not harder. We're not, We're not out of gas, if that makes any sense, especially with the Knight of Pentacles here. There's a patience with him. There's a, like I said, a dependability within us, a strength, a resilience. And so with the Nine of Wands in the midweek, we may be looking at things from a perspective of experiences that we've been through in the past and how we can use that knowledge to further progress the decisions we make this week. moving forward in a way that is smarter, not harder, that is directed, protected. There could be, with the nine aspect of this, some of us deciding to depart or shift course, or we've been in the process of shifting that course, and we are now beginning to make moves or motions towards the new choice, the new desire, the new outcome, right? But we are ready for it. We are looking at things through a very, I feel like, a focused lens, using our past experience as a, like, almost an educational filter to get us there. I hope that makes sense. And part of the reason why I want to say that is because this test of strength, perseverance, goes nicely with the endurance we see here with the Knight of Pentacles. Meaning, yes, there may be challenges. Yes, there may be mountains. Yes, the path is golden. Yes, the choice is there. Yes, there's this desert to cross, but we have crossed sort of many deserts in our life, and there's light on the other side, right? There is truth on the other side. There is truth in the experiences that we've had or the challenges that we've faced, and there is value or gifts or opportunities, learnings, education that is acquired through those challenges. And I get this feeling of this sense of, at least with these two cards together, that we might be in this place of kind of adjusting our 3D experience and our previous past experience into productive forward movement. Okay? I hope that makes sense. Let's look at the third card, or the end of the week card. It is Temperance. I love it. Moderation and equilibrium. Now, Temperance is Major Arcana. So with this slow energy, Temperance is about patience, ultimately. It is the angel that's pouring the two cups of water, right? He's got one foot on the ground, the earth, which would be the Knight of Pentacles, and one foot in the water, which is the emotions. But he's keeping them balanced, and he is about a higher spiritual perspective. That could be some of the Nine of Wands influence, too, of taking some of our previous experience and putting it to good use to help us to understand how to bring in that balance, peace, harmony at a very big level, at an empowered level, not at a level of forceful action, but at a level of almost passive neutrality. But in there's a strength in that passive neutrality. There's a strength in that awareness of kind of being connected to everything, and that with this temperance, with this connection to spirit, with this patience with ourselves, with the situation, with another, we're gonna get there, right? I like Temperance ending out the week, meaning we reach a plateau or a space where we feel empowered, and there may even be an opportunity to rest or heal here, to reconfigure or resettle things in a way that very much works for us or our pursuits at this time, okay? Let's go to the Cosmic Insights Oracle. So this is caution. Find out more information. Don't overwork yourself. This is a week of restoration, guys. Some of you can be resting, certainly, with this Knight of Pentacles, Nine of Wands, Temperance. But we're not moving forward. I have to say that. We may be taking small steps or measured steps with the Knight of Pentacles, Nine of Wands combo there, and the Patience of Temperance. Caution tells us, don't overdo it. You don't have to sweat this. You understand that the challenge may be there, or we've faced past challenges, but we don't have to repeat them. We can handle these things differently on our own timeline, in our own way, with our own sort of sense of self-assuredness, patience, intelligence, in a way that allows us to work, like I said, smarter, not harder. That is the Nine of Wands. And this is what caution is telling us. Don't overwork yourself. Find out more information. Be introspective this week. Go, you know, with every step, every choice, every decision, make it intentional this week, is my feeling of what these cards are saying. I don't know why, but I've been just feeling that these cards are really big. Like, I can't put my finger on it, or it just, like my gut feels like something is changing, even if we are not realizing that it's changing. And this almost, that heart with the little medical symbol on it, says to me that this is almost a time of like slowing down and healing ourselves as we process and get ready to begin to take steps towards the new. And being patient with ourselves, with others, with situations, and allow them to sort of transform as we kind of transform ourselves in the moment. This feels very present moment to me. Like as much as we can stay in the present moment this week is going to serve us very well. The Nine of Wands would be a little bit about reflection of the past, but using that awareness or intelligence or experience from past situations, relationships, whatever it is, putting it to good use in the present, ending the things that need to sort of end or coming to terms with them, and then moving forward, like, in this measured peace. That's the best way I can describe it. All right, so the next card is from the Star Maiden or Star Maiden Tarot. It's only a major arcana deck, so I used it this month as a message from spirit, kind of to let us know also what's sort of at work this week. Wow, we have lust, or card number 11, which is power. Excuse the nudity, I'm probably gonna get in trouble for that, but whatever. I believe this is the Devil card. It's gotta be. Devil is Capricorn energy. Devil can be about obsession, it can be about addiction, it can be about things where we feel stuck, harnessed, trapped, very desirous of. It doesn't always have to be a bad card, right? But it is a card of, like my feeling is the devil always shows us where we are our weakest, right? So that we can sort of shore up against that. And that might be why we're seeing this sort of patience here, is because whatever we might be ending or coming to terms with or shifting away from, maybe presented this wild party that looks like that's going on in the lust card. It may have been something that we have been focused on for a very long time or holding on to, with huge hopes about it being a certain thing, and it's not necessarily what we need right now or what we want or what we're working towards. We may need to find a new desire or a new shift or change or a new way of approaching it. Maybe we're going about it in too wild of a manner. I do like that this says associates with power. So for me, that speaks to like the endurance and the patience that I feel, like the quietness that's in the tarot for the week. There could be, for some of you, the devil can represent also fun. Like it can represent it having a little bit of indulgence, maybe having an extra glass of wine or a cute date, getting laid. Just don't let it overpower you in any way, shape, or form, or overtake you. I don't think that it's going to with all of these other cards present. I feel like if there is opportunities to enjoy this week, Spirit's saying, go ahead, enjoy, embrace. If there's a new desire on the forefront that we want to work towards and that we need to begin to shift our perspective towards, enjoy the feeling of that, and let go of anything that maybe felt heavy, that we felt chained to potentially in the past. Let's go to the clarifiers and see what's going on there. All right, so we have King of Pentacles, more stable, grounded earth energy, manifestation, money, career, giving, being generous, generous with ourselves, being an authority, channeling that divine masculine energy of steadiness, generosity, really feeling ideally in control of our situation around us and what we can give to it. So I really like that he's here. A lot of earth energy too with Capricorn, the Knight of Pentacles and the King of Pentacles. Again, he associates with the earth signs. So being grounded this week, being focused, looking at our money, looking at our finances, how do we manifest that? How do we make it bigger, better? That could be some of this lust and the power of, yeah, I do want more. How do I begin to create more? Well, be patient and look at what it is that you want. More love, more money, more better relationships, whatever it is. Now's the time to kind of set focus or set plans to it. The next card is the Seven of Wands, more wands energy. Wands, again, being fire, desire. The Seven of Wands can be about holding the line. Thank God her breasts are covered at this point. And the Seven of Wands can be about holding the line, keeping a boundary in place, fighting for what we know to be true spiritually. There is a slight upper hand with the Seven of Wands that we might have the higher ground, even though it may not feel like it. Like, there could be a little bit of a struggle energy going on in the Seven of Wands, but ultimately, his one foot being slightly higher always indicates that we do have the high ground, or we have an outcome that will be successful as long as we sort of toe the line for it, keep the boundary, keep the focus, fight the good fight, so to speak. And then let's see the last clarifier, Eight of Swords. The Eight of Swords is air energy. It is the mind, what we communicate, our thoughts. It is an energy of sort of feeling stuck, trapped, and limited. But the truth of the matter is what she doesn't see is that the swords are all behind her and she can easily step forward and remove herself from the situation. I think that this Eight of Swords connects to this Nine of Wands in the midweek. I think some of this is about the reflection of the past and releasing ourselves from the thoughts or, missed communications, any sort of fear that we may be having. It almost feels to me like the Seven and the Eight are not fighting it out, but it is this kind of back and forth energy of spirit wants one thing, our mind might be telling us, oh no, we can't. And this is why we have this sort of clarity of being in the present moment. Don't go deep into the past or into our thoughts and get caught there. Toe the line, stay manifesting, stay grounded, stay practical. Yes, go through some of these thoughts. Understand where our limitations lie with this Eight of Swords, but also understand that we can free ourselves from those limitations at any time that we choose. And I think some of those limitations can be some of this, you know, lust, devil, potential devil energy, right? Is that it may be ideas, thoughts that we were tethered to, ideas of lack or worry, fear, feeling like we can't move forward. This feels like we can. We need to be patient. We need to be focused. We need to be like that caution card says. It's like work smarter, not harder, or work, you know, what did it say? It said, sorry, don't overwork yourself. So be patient with yourself, with your thoughts, whatever it is you might be communicating, and take really, like I said, well thought out, measured steps or decisions forward in everything that you do this week. I think that there's an opportunity here with that lust card too. The word underneath it is power. We could be gaining power over past situations, relationships, thoughts, ideas, fears that used to limit us. And that's where the Seven of Wands kind of has to maybe fight with it a little bit. I will say this, Temperance is associated here at the end of the week with Sagittarian energy, which is a fire sign. We see a lot of earth and fire at work here. And they are, I don't want to say opposite, right? But earth and water are more compatible, but fire and earth are connected, if that makes sense. And so they do, one tempers the other, like earth tempers fire, in my opinion. Fire can scorch the earth, but I do feel like it is about remaining very focused this week, very patient. There's a sort of a nurturing, and of the fiery cards, right, Temperance is probably one of the most nurturing of the fire element cards, in my opinion, the most healing. So healing the spirit this week and keeping a very centered, grounded, present-minded focus is really going to serve us maybe in the days and weeks ahead. We'll see how this energy changes in the dailies throughout this week. So it'll be interesting. Let's go to the grounding stone. This is just an energy to ground in and remind ourselves to be in during this week. Oh, I love it. So it's clarity. Sorry, this broke in half a long time ago and I had put super glue on it, got dirty. But the word is clarity. This is about finding that clarity this week, that peace of mind, that steadiness, that reliability, that present-minded moment space. As I'm reading this, I hope I can shift into this energy because I feel like the reason why I'm off is because I'm not in this energy. If I'm like gonna be completely 100% honest with you all, my nervous system has been like wrecked the last 2 weeks. I lost my cat. There's been a lot of stuff that's gone on. But getting this sense of clarity or grounding in this clarity of who we are, the strength we have within us, the power that resides within us, the opportunity to heal ourselves as we take forward steps towards what we desire and face some of the things that potentially we maybe feared or limited us or scared us or that we didn't want to see. As I look at that blindfold on the Eight of Swords there, we may have to take the blindfold off and look, but we're gonna realize in that looking that those swords are behind us. They're not in front of us. We can move forward. And that's some of that Nine of Wands energy also about that personal completion that's happening in this midweek. There's something that we are becoming aware of through this clarity that will be, I don't know why I get this feeling, it's going to be substantial if you're in this energy. And what I mean by substantial is it has a bit of a long-term feel to it. Like this could be the next 3 months or 6 months of a project that's set out or a path that we begin to take towards a goal, relationship, outcome, increase in finance, whatever that is. This is the beginning of the door opening for us to begin to set that up. But we're clearing out sort of the detritus or the limiting whatever from the past that we no longer need, that doesn't get to come along for the ride. And so ground in this clarity of thought, communication, be in the present moment and be patient and kind to yourself this week as you go through it. And let's see how these cards evolve. I hope that makes sense to you guys. If you enjoyed the reading, please hit that thumbs up button. Leave me a question or comment. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, hitting that notification bell. Watch the video in its entirety. And saying this at the end is kind of useless, but it does help the algorithm. Any of my videos, rewatch my videos. All of that stuff helps. And I look forward to seeing you all tomorrow to see how this energy, you know, further, you know, changes or indicates to us what's ahead in the week. Have a wonderful day and take care. Bye.